think it's the living that will have ultimate judgment over you.
Why are you doing this? What do you want?
Because the dead will have no claim over your soul.
No, I'm not gonna do it! I'm not gonna do it!
But you may be mistaken. But I am still among you. When faced with death, who should live versus who will live are two entirely separate things.
If it's Halloween, it must be Saw.
You will be put to the test.
Saw 6.
He helped me.
Fuck! What the fuck?
Saw 10, everybody!
Saw X, aka... Fuck, I don't know what the fuck! Was this the best Saw movie since the original?
Yes! It actually felt more like the original Saw than anything.
Agreed.
Yeah, that's gonna be
nice. Oh my god. I'm surprised by how legitimate good it is. Like, I was just expecting fun. No, I got something great.
Yeah, like, the gore was great. The traps were amazing.
Fucking horrific.
The traps were some of the most creatively evil things I've ever seen.
Exactly.
Out of John Kramer's mind.
To be fair, there's more people out there that are evil than John Kramer.
No, I know, but John Kramer's mind when it comes to these traps.
Oh,
is
yeah.
Deliciously evil.
Agreed.
Or is it technically Satan-like?
I don't know, because all the people in the traps are terrible.
Yeah, I mean. Okay, so this is the one time. I think one of the few times in a Saw movie. Where you just hate everyone involved in the games.
Yeah, I mentioned a couple days ago I want to see Jigsaw killing douchebaggery, Eli Roth douchebags. This is it! This
we
is
found it.
It! We found it! Oh my.
We fucking found it!
Oh my god!
This is also the Saw movie with technically the most survivors in a movie.
Agreed!
Well, technically, since one of the survivors got immediately killed afterwards.
Exactly, because... We'll get to the doctor, but wow. Yeah, no, if... Fuck.
Oh, man.
I don't know what the fuck I watched. It's that's the feeling. I don't know what the fuck... Was this good? No, it was great.
It was great.
Like, the last...
This is some of the... This is perfect Halloween movie material.
Exactly. Okay, I need to mention this. Fuck Lionsgate for releasing this in September. Should have been released in Halloween.
Yes! You've robbed us!
Exactly! And can I tell you why?
Go
they
ahead.
Wanted to compete with Barbenheimer with Dog Patrol.
Yeah. But you know what? I don't care. This movie was great.
I know. It's so fucking fantastic. Oh my god. After seeing this, I'm like, I hope the guy that got to direct this directs a fuck ton more of these.
Yes! Yes!
Oh my god.
I love how they... Okay, so basic synopsis. We're not gonna go into spoiler territory
yet.
So we'll give you a count for when we do.
Mm-hmm.
Basic synopsis is that John Kramer has cancer.
Obvious. It's a Saw film.
Yeah. This does take place before John dies, or is this
basically
a rebooted?
It takes place in Saw in between Saw 1 and 2.
Yeah. Yeah, during the... When he's training Amanda.
And Hoffman.
Holy shit.
Yeah, there's so much.
Oh my god. I know it's bad video shit to say I'm speechless, to have no words come out of my mouth, but... In this case, I think it's a good thing.
Agreed. Oh, fuck.
So, I'm just gonna straight up say it right off the bat. 10 out of 10.
Fuck. I mean, this is gonna be the first time. I love it, but I don't love it as much as you. I give it a 9 out of 10.
Oh, fuck. We finally switched.
Exactly, like...
You're usually Mr. 10, now you're 9.
Exactly, I'm like... It's... Okay. What's preventing? I don't know. It deserves a 10 spot, but... Oh my... But here's the thing. Saw was a... Okay, the first Saw is a modern Halloween classic. Well, this is a movie for Saw fans. And I drew a distinction where I should be giving this a 10 as a Saw fan, but if you're a regular movie fan...
If you're a Saw fan, it's a straight 10. If you're a Halloween horror kind of fan...
Just a regular cinephile.
Yeah, just a regular Joe watching a movie... then this is a 9. But exactly. It's a high 9.
Exactly. It's a strong 9. Like, exactly. Oh my god. I'm just gonna say this. Fuck that we got Jigsaw. Fuck that. Fuck that we got Spiral. This should have been the Saw movie we wanted.
Yeah.
Like, well, and I liked Jigsaw and Spiral. Those were my introductions to Saw.
Let me continue a bit of the synopsis because I think I went basically only a few lines in.
Yeah,
dude. Basically, after he gets diagnosed with cancer, he goes, he gets scammed basically by these jackasses.
Eli Roth douchebags,
and basically a taxi driver, the guy who. Well, that's a mid-credits scene, so...
Yeah, we'll talk about the mid-credits after, once he gets spoiler territory.
Yeah. There were at least 5 others involved in this. Mm-hmm. It is... And once he finds out he got scammed, he goes full Saw on their asses. He goes full Jigsaw.
Yeah.
On them for, for ruining the hopes of, terminal cancer patients.
Which...
Not even just him, just other patients in general.
34 people. God, these guys are monsters.
Well, one monster.
Well, yeah, true. But still, fuck those guys.
Yeah.
But yeah. I don't know what to say.
You're not. Let's go into spoilers.
Let's go to 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Hoffman's back!
Hoffman's back. Amanda's back. Oh my god, I can't believe I'm saying this. I missed the 3 of them.
Exactly.
I mean, we only get Hoffman for one scene, and that's during the mid-credit sequence. This is basically Amanda coming back and the John Kramer interactions again.
Exactly, which are fantastic.
And surprisingly somewhat sentimental because of the fact that Amanda doesn't want Kramer to, die.
Exactly.
Go down by cancer like that, and,
she feels like she's not worthy of his legacy.
Exactly.
Like, it's... The performances are really strong. Like, I can't believe I'm saying this, but both Tobin Bell and Shawnee Smith deserve Oscar nominations at best. Oh, yeah. Because my god, these are real people. I'm not seeing performances. These are real damaged people.
And one psychopathic doctor.
Oh my god.
So let's get into our victims.
My god, these are easily.
We got the taxi driver who basically took John Kramer to the fake hospital or fake operation.
Yep.
Place. Basically, his trap was having 2 pipe bombs strapped to his arms, and he had to cut it out,
mm-hmm.
which is
horrific.
But he actually manages to survive. He survived the game.
Exactly.
So, John Kramer immediately, gets him medical attention and mm-hmm. shit. Then afterwards, he basically has Amanda capture each of the other members minus one. Basically, that one being brought in brings himself in later by accident when, in accordance to apparently a plan on them, tricking the doctor woman to summon him via phone call.
Yeah. Fuck, these people are scum. Like, I thought Jigsaw, yes, he's a bad guy, but Fuck you. He's a saint compared to these people.
Well, he's a saint compared to one person.
The doctor.
Let's talk about that bitch. Like, we know Jigsaw's a villain and, villain protagonist, whatever. There's a whole list of reasons why, in some cases, you want to see the villain protagonist, do their thing.
Mm-hmm.
But this is one of the few times where I legit said, yeah, John, you are no longer villain protagonist for this movie. We found someone who's more evil than you.
Exactly.
Like, you know you're... I'm saying this nicely when I say these words. The doctor bitch tried to kill a child using one of John's games.
Oh, yeah, that's... Oh, my God, that was like, fuck you, bitch. You cold-blooded bitch.
Not only that, she killed one of the other people who got dragged in with her who survived the game, mind you.
Yeah.
Meaning she was supposed to, you know, get medical attention and shit. But that's when things go wrong for a bit. And that's around the time the survivor dies. We're not going to go into who these guys are just so you can watch the movie peacefully. But the only one we're going to spoil is the doctor bitch because...
Fuck.
Fuck her.
She's an awful person. Oh, and can I tell you something? Can I spoil this?
Go ahead. We're in spoiler territory.
She lives at the end, and I'm on two minds on this. On the one hand, it's frustrating, but at the same time, there are fates worse than death.
Oh, yeah. Her life is ruined now. She has permanent scars from the encounter with Jigsaw. John.
Yeah, and also, due to what she did to the kid, I imagine the kid told her father what the bitch did, and she got arrested.
Oh, yeah, definitely. Hell, we can actually make it so that John can actually get away with this scot-free.
Exactly.
Like, this is one of the few times where you can legit say he got away scot-free because the bitch actually...
Did all those horrible things.
You can actually place the blame on her.
Yeah, and also...
And no one would bat an eye.
And also there's footage.
Yeah.
Of her, like, you know, torturing the child.
Yeah, like... Holy shit.
Yeah. I want to talk about the end credits because...
Yeah, let's get to the mid-credits scene. We get Hoffman's back. And basically we get another... Jigsaw game going right before we go into the true credits.
Yeah, and basically, here's my favorite line in the movie. Of all the people to scam, you pick John Kramer? Well, that's epic bad luck.
You know what? Yeah.
That summarizes the movie.
I mean, for God's sakes, this is like the worst luck of all time.
Yeah.
I've ever seen. You are a scammer, and you picked Jigsaw to scam? And mind you, the doctor bitch knew... It's him. She knew from moment one, the second she heard the name, that it was him.
Mm-hmm.
She had it coming.
Yeah.
She thought she could outsmart the fucking Jigsaw murderer?
No. Jigsaw's a lot smarter than her. Oh, yeah. And I want to mention this. This is just something I noticed in the film. So the taxi driver's name is Diego, which is... I'm not gonna say, but yeah, like, I was like, huh, well, I need to say it. I'm in the movie, I guess.
Well, sort of. Your name is Diego.
I know,
that also means you got tortured by John Kramer.
Yeah, I mean, and here's my theory. I bet Diego was the one who, along with Logan Nelson, was the one who helped Dr. Gordon... capture Hoffman. That's my theory. That Diego, the character, the taxi driver, helped Dr. Gordon to...
You know what? I can imagine it, surprisingly, seeing as how anytime someone survived the games, they'd end up being apprenticed by the guy.
Exactly. So,
or they were at least apprenticed by the apprentices.
Exactly. So, you know what? That's my theory. The taxi driver, Logan Nelson, Dr. Gordon are the ones that, you know, captured Hoffman and saw 3D. That's my theory. So, yeah, final score, 9 out of 10. But as a movie, but as a Saw movie, 10 out of 10.
Yeah. Yeah, same thing. 9 out of 10 as a normal movie, 10 out of 10 as a Saw movie.
Yeah, go see this. I want a fuck ton more of these from this director.
Yeah.
The next Saw movie I want... is the Hoffman Jigsaw movie where it's just Jigsaw's relationship with Hoffman, similar to how this movie explores
Amanda's and Kramer's relationship.
Exactly.
Because we do get a lot of interactions with them throughout the game.
Yeah, and I want the next movie to be about Hoffman and him. So, you know, Twisted Pictures and Kevin Grutter, if you're watching this, we want the next Saw film to be the Kramer and Hoffman show. Make it happen.
Please.
See you later.